Hi, Andrey here. Welcome to the Practical Health Channel. Today we'll talk about circadian rhythms again. But this time we'll talk about circadian rhythms from a visual perspective. I love visuals. I'm a visual person. And from my years of work experience in the business intelligence field in the technology segment, I work at Cisco Systems, I found that complex concepts can be quite easily explained through a good graph, a good picture, a good visual. So in this video, I'll talk about my personal view, my personal visual representation of improving circadian rhythms, or how I think about improving circadian rhythms when, for some reason, they get disrupted. Coming up. Here's my graph. Sorry for my handwriting. It's not great handwriting, but at least I did my best. Before we'll talk about the specific points, my focus areas, let me briefly explain what this graph is all about. The horizontal axis represents time, 24-hour period from 5 a.m. one day to 5 a.m. the other day, the next day. The vertical axis represents activity level. So when it's above the horizontal line, it means I'm awake, I'm active. And when it's below the horizontal line, it means I'm in the sleep state. And this is how my day usually looks like. I wake up at about 5:30 a.m., ramp up on my activities in the morning, reaching the maximum at about 10 a.m., then slow down in the second half of the day, get to sleep at about 9:30 p.m., have 8 hours of sleep, and then wake up at about 5:30 a.m. next day. So this is how my typical day looks like. The fundamental idea of having a strong circadian rhythm is to maximize level of physical activity during the day. So basically we're talking about this shaded area. Everyone knows that if you have a great night's sleep, you'll have a lot of energy. You can do basically whatever you want the next day. But it works the other way around. A great active day can lead to a great night's sleep with a good share of REM and deep sleep. Basically, this is two sides of the same coin. So my goal is to maximize this shaded area. But since the number of active hours during the day is limited, it's about 16, so the way how I can do that is to maximize level of physical activity. So my focus area number one is to stay as active as possible during the day. So I work out, I move around, and I do whatever possible to stay active. Focus area number two goes along the same lines, how to maximize this shaded area. And my approach here is quite simple. I want to ramp up my activities in the morning as fast as possible, using external cues, light, temperature and noise, and internal processes, having a healthy breakfast and working out in the morning. By the way, we have a standalone video about how to wake up fast in the morning. This video is about 4 years old and was one of the first videos on our channel. But even today, as of summer of 2022, YouTube considers this video as number one video in that search category. So if you search for how to wake up fast, you'll see that video. Pretty exciting, right? Okay, but going back to our list, the second point is I try to ramp up my activities in the morning as fast as possible. Focus area number three is to have a great sleep routine. That, together with a high level of physical activity during the day, will lead to a great night's sleep. And here again, we're talking about leveraging external cues and internal processes. From the external cues perspective, I'm trying to keep my bedroom dark, quiet, and cool. And from internal processes, I'm trying to give enough time for my body to finish up all metabolic processes of digesting food. So I'm trying to have my dinner at 5, 6 p.m. I'm trying to avoid any workouts in the second half of the day. And the last is coffee. I love coffee, but as you might know, a half time of caffeine is about 5 hours. So it takes about 9-10 hours to get majority of the caffeine from the body. So I'm trying to avoid drinking coffee in the second half of the day. Finally, focus area number four is to have a consistent schedule. And here we're talking about to wake up at the same time in the morning, to get to sleep at the same time in the evening, to have food intakes at the same time. So in my case, it's about 10 a.m. for the lunch and 5, 6 p.m. for the dinner. I'm trying to work out at the same time of the day. So this line is exactly the same day after day. So my body knows that I need cortisol at about 5:30 a.m. So when I wake up, so I feel alert and energized. And I need melatonin at about 9 p.m. to get asleep fast. That's it for today. So this is my graph. This is my list of focus areas. Basically, this is what's hard-coded in my brain when I think about improving my circadian rhythms. Briefly, I'm trying to ramp up my activities in the morning as fast as possible, stay active during the day, have a consistent schedule, get to sleep at the same time, and then have a great night's sleep, so I have a lot of energy the next day. I'm doing my best to avoid this dotted line, so when I ramp up slowly, have a low level of physical activity, sometimes I have an inconsistent schedule, and then I have a shallow sleep. As an outcome, I have no energy for the next day. It's not fun. Okay, thank you for watching. I hope you picked up something useful, something interesting out of this video that will help you to improve your circadian rhythm and your health in general. And that's the goal of our channel, to help you to get healthier. If you like this video, give us a like. If you'd like to share your personal ideas on improving circadian rhythms, please do so in the comment section. I read every single comment. And if you're not a subscriber, please subscribe. It will help us to convince YouTube that we're a real channel. So YouTube will start promoting our videos, making them more visible to more people. See you next time. Bye.